Then we are going to banjil the fish with our sauce. Oh, look how beautiful it is. Look at this.
Cooking Appa.
Hi, this is Cooking Appa. As you can see from here, Appa has a half beautiful barramundi fish head. Barramundi is what we normally call siakap. Yeah, but this is a 3 kg barramundi actually. Wild barramundi actually tastes superb. You must try some wild siakap fish which is bigger than 3 kg. Seriously, it tastes different. Right, so I'm going to steam the fish head here. Right after that, I'm going to make some jiang zhen. Yeah, make it into a jiang zhen fish. So this is what we really need to make the jiang zhen. Jiang zhen, as the name suggests, direct translation, it means steam it with fermented beans. And I will be using two kinds of fermented beans here. Focus. This is 1 tablespoon of salted black bean. Now, these things about salted black bean is you need to crush it or you need to press it so that the flavor can come out easier, can release easier. Then I have also 1 tablespoon of taochu, fermented soya bean. So it is going to be a combination between these two beans. And the rest of the ingredient, we will need some chili. I have approximately 5 pieces of big chili here. Later, I'm going to blend it. Some few pieces of ginger, shallot, and also garlic. And there's another 2 things we need. It's here. We will need some tomato sauce and we will need some plum sauce. That's it we need to make the jiang zhen sauce. Not difficult at all. Alright, my steamer has been heated up to the temperature I wanted. Usually for steamed fish, depending what kind of temperature your steamer can go, try to use the highest temperature that you can get. Mine is about 120 Celsius, right? So I'm going to steam this for approximately 10 minutes and let's go and make our sauce. So first thing first, we need to make the chili paste. Let's put in the big chili. Some garlic, shallot, and also ginger. So the good thing about home cooking is you always get to control how you want to do it, yeah? Control the spiciness especially. See it on the power. Done. This is how fast it is. This is a very cheap and also useful blender from Kenwood. 100 plus only, very cheap. 100 plus ringgit Malaysia. Alright, this kind of consistency, and then we are going to saute the chili paste. Alright, so give it some oil. Do be a bit generous of the oil whenever you are making anything with chili. Then heat it up. Actually, even before it is heated up, we can already put in the blended chili. I'm using big chili here, so it's not going to be spicy at all. I'm also going to add in the taochu, yeah, the fermented bean paste, and also the salted black bean. See, the chili can actually soak up the oil very fast. If you think it's too dry, feel free to add in more oil, which I am going to do so. We still have our tomato sauce and also plum sauce, yeah? Those things we haven't added in first. We're just going to, let's first saute this using a medium heat for the next 3 to 4 minutes before we continue. Wow, it's already very fragrant. Woohoo, I wish you could smell this. Remember, there are two kinds of fermented beans I use here. Number one is a salted black bean, and you need to crush it or press it. Number two is actually the tauchu, fermented soya bean. These two will really bring out the flavor of what we call the fermented beans. Are seriously beautiful combination. All right, this is approximately after about 2 to 3 minutes sauteing the chili paste under about medium heat. Yeah. Now I'm going to add in some other seasoning. So we are going to put this into low heat first so that it doesn't go chao da, right? First of all, let me off the heat totally. I have some plum sauce. Ooh, very thick. This is a bad example. You should always take out the plum sauce earlier. All right, approximately 1 tablespoon of plum sauce, then 2 to 3 tablespoons of tomato sauce. A bit more is fine also. Then I'm going to give it a bit of salt here. Some sugar. Oops, actually too much sugar. Very dangerous to add sugar like that. Don't follow what I did. Take out some. Then I'm going to add in some of my cooking apple chicken stock powder. A bit of light soy sauce. And some water to dilute it. Now I'm going to on the heat again. So now we can carefully saute everything again for a couple of minutes, then basically it is done. Wow, look at this. Look at how beautiful is our jiang zhen sauce. Look at this. Woo-hoo. And it's super fragrant right now. I wish you can smell this. Last time I only used tauchu. Then I always find not enough. Then recently I went to one restaurant. I noticed that their jiang zhen sauce is quite dark. Then I was thinking, what make it so dark? I suspect is they actually use the salted black bean as well. All right, it's very thick actually. I don't mind adding it a little bit more water here. Right, so basically our sauce is ready. Just wait for the fish and we can pour the sauce all over the fish. Look at how beautiful it is. All right, our fish is ready and I have removed the fishy water. Yeah, remember we don't want the fish, steam fish water. Then we are going to bungee the fish with our sauce. Oh, look how beautiful it is. Look at this. I don't have fresh coriander with me. It will look nicer if we can put some fresh coriander on top. Right, there you go. That's it. Here's my very simple jiang zhen yu tou, steamed fish head with fermented bean. If you like my video, do share my video on Facebook to your friends. Come to Cooking Apa Facebook fan page to click like and follow button. Follow up on Instagram and subscribe to Cooking Apa YouTube channel. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.